In this video, I want to tell you a little something about backward induction by asking these questions. What is backward induction? How does backward induction work? And what's an example of backward induction? Let's get started. What's backward induction? Backward induction is a logical reasoning process that's rooted in game theory. It's a repetitive reasoning process that involves reasoning backward in time. An individual or a player or more players reason from the end of a problem by looking at what they want to achieve. Let's call what they wish to achieve the payoff or final outcome. So the players look at the payoff or final outcome and start their reasoning from there. Then the players determine what the best actions are to reach that final outcome, goal, or destination. What choices do they need to make to get there? This process of reasoning allows the player to think of the payoff or final outcome and then apply the sequence of happenings to decide what to do at a particular stage in the game to reach the payoff. So this is what we call backward induction, and people have used it since 1944 when John von Neumann and Oscar Morgenstern published the book Theory of Games and Economic Behavior. Reinhard Selten also used this process of reasoning in 1965 when he devised the subgame Perfect Nash Equilibrium.
This subgame, Perfect Nash Equilibrium, has an emphasis on the difficulty of commitment and on credible plans of action, and it remains the main concept for the strategic analysis of dynamic games. It's been applied myriad of times in diverse models ranging over all social sciences, but also in biology and computer science.
How does backward induction work?
A player uses backward induction to decide what move to make at a particular stage in a game by a process of reasoning backward in time. As I said before, the player considers the final outcome or the payoffs first and then considers the best options to acquire the payoff.
Backward induction only works if all players are rational. So it only works if the players always select an action that maximizes their payoff. However, one or two players being rational isn't enough. Each player should also believe that all other players are rational. Even this is not enough though. Each player should believe that all other players know that all other players are rational, and so on. In other words, rationality should be common knowledge.
Moreover, let's say you have different players and they each have to perform an action before another one can do something. In this theory, a player who makes the last move uses an optimal strategy determined by this theory. Thereafter, the action of the player before the last one is determined by the last player's action, and so forth. The gaming process moves backward until the best optimal action for each player or subgame is determined. This might sound a little vague, so let me explain it in more detail.
What's an example of backward induction? Here you see a simple sequential game between two players. The labels with player 1 and player 2 within them are the information sets for players 1 or 2, respectively. The numbers in the parentheses at the bottom of the tree are the payoffs at each respective point. So that's the first thing we want to take a look at. What's the payoff? Player 2 has 4 options. When we look at player 2's choices to the left, assuming it's a male player, he can choose between up, which would give him 1.3 points, or down, which would give him 3.2 points. When we look at his choices to the right, he can choose between up, which would give him 4.2 points, or down, which would give him 3.1 points. We must always assume that the players think rationally and want to maximize their payoff in any given situation. That's why choosing right and then up, which would give player 2 4.2 points, would be the best payoff. And that's why we can assume that that's the way player 2 wants to play it. Player 2 makes his choice known to player 1, who can now also maximize his payoff, assuming it's also a male player, and by doing so, they can work together to reach the highest payoff, 4.2 points. In other words, now they can start playing the game. The game is sequential, so player 1 makes the first decision, chooses between left or right, and player 2 makes his decision after player 1, and can choose between up or down. In other words, the result is an equilibrium found by backward induction of player 1 choosing right and player 2 choosing up. And what's highlighted in blue is the path which will lead to the best outcome, 4.2 points.
So what I just explained to you is the sequence we use when we use backward induction. I just induced backward for you.
Moreover, we could easily set up a game like the one I just told you about using two companies as players. This game could include product release scenarios. If company 1 wanted to release a product, what might company 2 do in response? Will company 2 release a similar competing product? By forecasting sales of this new product in different scenarios, we can set up a game to predict how events might unfold. What you see right here is an example of how we could model such a game. So feel free to pause the video and peruse the model if you haven't already done it. And there you have it. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video.
If you found this video interesting, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. In 2 weeks, I'll be back with a new video in my series on intellectual giftedness. I'm gonna tell you what can trigger OCD in a gifted person. Till then, I only want to say 3 things. Thank you for watching, take care, and bye for now.